Hi, my name is Arundhati, and today we are going to have an interesting conversation with Janhvi and Zoya.
You know, I feel like over this year, faces have become familiar, and I don't know, I think I've just gotten more relaxed with these interactions. You learn to have fun with it, I think. Yeah.
Tell me, Zoya, this is the first time you guys are also collaborating.
Yes.
Yeah, so how was that working? Just share the experience.
It was a very good experience working with her, and it was a very easy experience working with her because she came with absolutely no baggage. I was very clear about what I wanted for the part. And I needed somebody who is confident and who can be cheeky and who can be slightly, you know, coquettish and sexy and young. And but if you scratch the surface, there's a great depth and sensitivity and pain. And I needed a character like that. And I think she's extremely soulful, this girl, even though she...
Just look into her eyes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So when I met her and I narrated the script
the
to
story.
Her, I had seen her in Dhadak, and there were one or two scenes in Dhadak that made me feel that she's the girl that can totally be in my film. And I met her. I didn't know her that well. I'd been met socially, and I narrated the film to her. And just the way she took to the material, the kind of questions she asked me, and the enthusiasm that she had. I mean, you know, she came with no rubbish, like short film, digital platform, nothing. She was just asking me questions that were like very specific to the
like
part.
Regarding the character.
Yeah, and I got extremely excited about collaborating with her. And it was just really fun. My crew loved her. She came in with no, you know, we just
like
came in there.
After the Super 8 film.
A fresh slate.
Yeah.
And we, I think, co-created something quite special.
And how was it for you? I mean, Zoya is everyone's favorite director, right?
Yeah.
And also, yes. That's what all the youngsters are saying. Like, you are the favorite for all of us.
No, that's what everyone feels for sure. It was honestly a dream come true. And 6 days was too short, and I think we had a couple of days of readings before that. And I just wanted to be attentive and there every minute, because I felt like she has so much just knowledge and she's so sure of herself as a person, I think, and also as a filmmaker. And that doesn't mean she's not open to like collaborating and stuff. So it's like she gives you the freedom, but she also, I think, has such a fresh way of looking at things. And I don't know, it was just such an amazing experience. I don't know how to start and how to end, because
because you also have worked with icon like Surekha ji, right?
How
was that like?
About the experience of working with her, I just feel like it's so apparent how gifted she is. You know, I feel like she emits a different kind of energy, and I don't know if that comes with years of experience or if it's just some, there's just a certain like power in her eyes, I think. Like she's in a frame and she doesn't even have to do much, because she isn't very mobile in the film. She's restricted to the bed, and there's literally not much except her face that is doing the work, but that's more than enough. Like there's so much it's something else, like it's inexplicable almost. And to be able to witness that was
very fortunate to
feel,
right?
Yeah, for sure.
Was there any spooky experience during the filming that has happened? Because it is horror stories, right? So
I don't think we had any time. Even if there was a haunting on that set and there was a ghost, we wouldn't have noticed it. We would have been like, we are out of time.
Yeah.
Bye. Yeah, so we didn't have time. But I think we all, something weird happened when we wrapped. Everyone fell sick, like badly sick. And about 10 people. And that was a bit like weird. How and why that happened. People, and it was like kind of a food poisoning.
It
didn't happen to everybody who ate the same. It was weird. There was something weird about it, yeah.
But keeping that aside, was there any spooky experience that you guys have in life that you would like to share?
I'm doing a horror comedy called Ruabsa.
Right.
So on the set of that film, on the first day of shoot, there was a small insert shot of me picking up bread from the floor. In one moment, I had picked the bread up, but there were still a few pieces of bread on the floor. And a piece of bread levitated off of the ground. and then अपने fell back down. अपने आप मतलब हाथ फ्रेम में नहीं थे. पहले सोचा था कि शायद बाल में अटक के खिंच गया. बाल किधर और था, हाथ किधर और थे. ब्रेड अपने आप नाच रहा था फ्रेम में, पता नहीं क्यों. And it's recorded on camera. I'm sure they'll release it or something they'll do. But please watch that film also. It's cute.
And what about you? Have you ever?
I mean, I've kind of had an experience like that was strange. We were coming back in a car and we saw something in the middle of the road. And
what was that?
Yeah, we thought we hit it. We saw a woman and we thought we hit her. And there were 5-6 people in the car. And we swerved and we were under the impression we had hit her. And there was nobody there. There was nobody on the road. We stopped the car, got off, and that's what Talash was based on. But we don't know. I don't know. I can't explain it. It's one of those unexplained things that's happened to me in my life, and I can't explain it.
Okay, chalo, wish you all the best, and thank you so much for talking to us. Thank you. This is Arundhati signing off.